Spirit of the Lord is upon me, because he has anointed me to bring the good news to the poor. He has sent me to comfort the brokenhearted, and to proclaim that the captives will be released, and the prisoners will be freed, to proclaim the year of the Lord's favor, and the day of vengeance of our God.
The Lord reigns. Let the earth be glad. Let the distant shores rejoice. Clouds and thick darkness surround him. Righteousness and justice are the foundation of his throne. Fire goes before him and consumes his foes on every side. His lightning lights up the world. The earth sees and trembles. The mountains melt like wax before the Lord. Before the Lord of all the earth, the heavens proclaim his righteousness, and all peoples will see his glory.
What's up? Are you there? Are you muted? Passive aggressive interview. You're muted. You are muted. No one's more muted than you. I want you to be unmuted. You're muted. I'm gonna send you a message right now. I'm sending it. You are muted. Can you unmute yourself? You're muted. There's a certain. Oh,
there, can you hear me?
Oh yeah, yeah.
Yeah.
I thought this was gonna be a passive aggressive interview where I'm like,
guys, this is way better.
All right, Thrive Nation. On today's show, I'm gonna start off by sharing you what I believe to be the most single act of treachery of a U.S. American president. I'm gonna share with you the most.
Everything that you've described is true. That's their plans. But the problem with their plans is between them and their plans stands God.
Okay, wait a second.
We're going to talk about that today.
No, wait a second. What you said was too positive. Right. Okay. So at Revelation 18:4, okay, I'm going to read this. It says, "And I heard another voice from heaven saying, come out of her, my people, yet ye be not, that ye be not partakers of her sins, and that ye receive not of her plagues. I will say, you're the first guest we've ever had on the show who's referenced Revelation 18:4, so that gives you a mega point. Boop, boop. Carter, give me questions for both so far.
I don't have any questions right now. I'm just trying to withstand this roller coaster ride of positive and negative.
Roller coaster!
It's just all over.
This is what's coming. Okay, what's coming? Mark my words. Our friend Amanda Grace prophesied this in October of 2020. There will be a clash of the titans in Washington, D.C.
Wait a second. Just so much. It's so awesome. So good. So crazy. Okay. So the Olympics. Now, but let's talk about the Olympics. So what are you saying about the Olympics? Because there's a lot of people out there that are so excited about the Olympics. But every time in recent history that I've watched the Olympics, which I don't watch the whole Olympics at all, but when I watch the opening ceremony, I see these satanic opening ceremonies, and I'm going, I can't watch this crap. I cannot watch it. Tell me more about the Olympics.
Los Angeles Olympics, okay? In the 70s, they foretold, they showed a UFO landing in Los Angeles, and then they had an alien come out of, so they're foretelling what's coming.
You're saying so many things that no one ever says. So let's go back to this real quick here. So you said the deep state's going to pull the alien card. Did you hear that, Carter?
I did hear that.
Yeah. Okay, so what do you mean by they're going to pull the alien card?
You do not want to miss this incredible and powerful two-part video with Clay and myself. Click the link below and enjoy the video